number one, board consideration regarding settlement in the case of Jeffrey Chance versus Forsyth County. Tim Buckley, please.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, Mr. County Attorney Gerard, my name's Tim Buckley, counsel retained to represent Forsyth County with regard to two lawsuits filed by Mr. Jeffrey Chance. Allegations in those lawsuits have been well publicized, as have the various rulings favorable to the county along the way. Case was mediated in May of this year. Parties reached terms which were recommended for resolution by counsel and the insurer. Claims of Mr. Chance under this resolution would be dismissed and released without further litigation or expense to the county or its insurer, and insulating the county from any further claims or claims against other county employees or agents that would risk expense or exposure to the county. Upon execution of mutual releases under the terms of the proposed resolution, without any admission of liability by the county, upon payment of settlement funds in a total amount of $325,000, $225,000 of which would be paid by the insurer, $100,000 of which would be paid by the county, the lawsuit and any and all claims by Mr. Chance in the past, previously asserted or accrued up to the time of such settlement, would be closed and released, with each party to bear their own attorney's fees and expenses. So that is the proposal to the board in terms of approval of that proposed settlement. Thank you.
Thank you. What is the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, I'll make a motion that we accept the settlement agreement in the case of Jeffrey Chance versus Forsyth County as explained to Mr. Tim Buckley.
We have a motion.
I'll do a second for discussion. What was the breakdown of the insurance company's portion of the county's portion?
The insurance company would pay $225,000 of the settlement. The county would pay $100,000.
Thank you.
You did second that, is that correct? Is there any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. And that passes 4-0. Commissioner Tan being absent.
We all know that in this age of certain sorts of substance abuses, a lot of ferrous and non-ferrous metals are stolen, copper wiring, things of that nature. This is an attempt, I believe, by the General Assembly to empower sheriffs to get a better handle on that by requiring these dealers in secondhand metals to register.